Exis Labs, where the future is now.
This is Nasser Adil, security chief for the Exis Labs facility. Log entry November 3, 2145. We are seeing an increasing level of random and unexplained violence by Exis staff. The first incident occurred on October 13, 2145 at the Exis surface tunnel. One of the construction workers, Bill Sanders, was offloading a shipment of steel supports when the procurement manager stopped him. In the heated conversation that followed, Sanders grabbed a nearby pickaxe and lunged at the manager. Luckily, the argument beforehand generated a sizable crowd, and when Sanders attacked the manager, a number of men were able to subdue him. When we questioned Sanders afterwards, he seemed to have developed short-term amnesia. He didn't remember why he got so upset and attacked the manager. He only recalled stopping his loader and then moments later waking in the holding cell. Since that event, we have seen arguments progress more and more from heated shouting matches straight into outright brawls. The antagonists in these incidents all display the same conditions, as if they were suddenly possessed by violent anger, and then afterwards returned to normal. We have only one serious life-threatening case so far, where engineer Leon Powell was stabbed multiple times. I fear this is not the worst of our troubles, and have requested additional security personnel posted at critical junctions. Assist any immediate medical need, I have resupplied storage cabinet 965 with the accompanying code of 428. Sergeant Nasser Adil out. Nasser Adil, personal log dated November 12th, 2145. I have just received word from Central Authority that a UAC representative, Counselor Elliot Swan, will be arriving in a few days from Earth. The report states he will be reviewing all sectors of Mars City, including Exis Labs. I'm not sure that's a good idea in light of the recent events we've had here. The violent assaults that seem to plague Exis Labs have caused the civilian staff to be pretty wary of one another. And now, to top it all off, missing weapons. The cabinets in the security checkpoints were fully stocked 2 days ago, and now half the weapons are gone. I don't know how this situation occurred, but my Marines swear no one has access to the cabinets except for them. I've ruled out those assigned to me and other security personnel, but I can't figure out who else has those codes. To sum up, this is a bad situation, turning worse every day. My recent request for more manpower in Exis Labs was denied. It seems other sectors of Mars City are stretched thin, and the small reserves at the base are already allocated. I need to have faith in my current detachment of Marines that they will turn things around. I'll talk to Central again and see if Counselor Swan can bypass Exis. The last thing I want is some staff worker with a sudden episode of dementia murdering a VIP. I'm having enough problems trying to keep everyone here from killing each other. Sergeant Nasir Adil, signing off. This is Nasir Adil, security chief for the Exis Labs facility. Log entry, November 3, 2145. We are seeing an increasing level of random and unexplained violence by Exis staff. The first incident occurred on October 13, 2145 at the Exis surface tunnel. One of the construction workers, Bill Sanders, was offloading a shipment of steel supports when the procurement manager stopped him. In the heated conversation that followed, Sanders grabbed a nearby pickaxe and lunged at the manager. Luckily, the argument beforehand generated a sizable crowd, and when Sanders attacked the manager, a number of men were able to subdue him. When we questioned Sanders afterwards, he seemed to have developed short-term amnesia. He didn't remember why he got so upset and attacked the manager. He only recalled stopping his loader and then moments later waking in the holding cell. Since that event, we have seen arguments progress more and more from heated shouting matches straight into outright brawls. The antagonists in these incidents all display the same conditions, as if they were suddenly possessed by violent anger, and then afterwards returned to normal. We have only one serious life-threatening case so far, where engineer Leon Powell was stabbed multiple times. I fear this is not the worst of our troubles, and have requested additional security personnel posted at critical junctions. To assist any immediate medical need, I have resupplied storage cabinet 965 with the accompanying code of 428. Sergeant Nasser Adel out.
Spreading throughout the base, and if we don't act quickly, all could be lost. I understand you have a lot of questions, but I can't answer them right now. All I can say is, we need to get the teleporter in the next chamber working. But to do that, I need you to find a plasma inducer for the stabilizer bank. There's one in engineering. Now, if you head through the service tunnel, you can reach it. I'll unlock some doors. There. That will give you the necessary clearance. Now, please, get the inducer and hurry back. We don't have a lot of time. Please hurry.
This is Dmitry Lebedev, supply manager for the Exis Labs facility. Entry dated October 6, 2145. I've received the latest shipment of MK7 spacesuits from Earth today. They have a triple weave of titanium mesh on the outer layer for Class 5 excursions. With the ongoing construction requiring additional EVA time on the Martian surface, these new suits should hold up better. In the last 2 months, we've had a number of unexplained suit decompressions resulting in fatalities. In the case of technician Mike Stanley, the decompression was so rapid the resulting implosion caused him to almost liquefy and fuse with the suit interior. If it wasn't for his suit's name tag, there wouldn't be much to identify him. In each case, the penetrations and loss of pressure appear to occur from inside the suit rather than out. I can attest these suits were thoroughly inspected and micro-scanned after the incidents, and no material degradations were found. Per UAC EVA regulations, these suits before the accidents were properly stored and locked away to prevent any mishandling. I also followed up with the technicians on ensuring the suits had the necessary pre-EVA checklist before anyone reaches the Martian atmosphere. I'm hoping the new suits will address the issue. Each suit lost this way just means more paperwork for me, so... Along with the new suit shipment, we've received additional medical supplies. I've placed the extra packs in the storage cabinet 071 with the access code of 532. Dmitry Lebedev, end of log.
unlock some doors so you can make it back through operations.
Travis Folsom, construction supervisor for the... Travis Folsom, construction supervisor for the Exis Labs facility. We recently reached substantial completion on the facility's engineering sector and began work on the environmental systems sector early. At this rate, we should be able to impress the big boys up in Central Authority and score our completion bonuses. Last week, I reviewed the construction documents and found another item where we can cut costs. My glass subcontractor mentioned the Moxum pressure seals for the exterior windows can be replaced with much cheaper mix-up seals. I submitted the alternative material selection to the base architect for review. On our Tuesday progress meeting, he argued the Mixom seals aren't up to spec. He complained that those seals are inferior and could cause air leaks, glass blowout. What the hell does he know? That's like the draftsman thinks he's designed a fancy hotel. Hey, guess what? I was building shit before he was born. Anyway, I managed to get the Mixom seals ordered. I bypassed the architect and talked directly to corporate. I showed them the savings, and that sealed the deal. We'll be installing the exterior windows in environmental in a week, and he will never know the difference. I'm so convinced the glass and seals will hold up that I'm gonna take a rocket launcher, test it on those windows, and make me. That'll show the stupid architect. False him out!
Environmental breach detected. Please activate emergency shutters. Environmental breach.
Ah! This is Bernice Tooley, operations coordinator stationed in Exis Labs. I would like to file my third formal complaint to Central Authority about the problems with the work environment here in Exis. It has become increasingly difficult to be productive while construction is going on throughout the facility. The construction workers are rude, lack common courtesies, and are overtly sexist. They use our office space as an unauthorized shortcut and track dirt and debris as a result. In addition to their mess, they insist on drilling and hammering during our core staff hours. Some of them have repeatedly made inappropriate comments that clearly fall under sexual harassment. When I approached the construction supervisor to remedy the situation, he told me in no uncertain terms to mind my own business. Actually, his exact words were, "Don't worry your pretty little head about it." We are already on edge with the unexplained events occurring around the facility, and to add this insult to our tight schedule is too much to bear. If I cannot persuade Central Authority to take this complaint seriously, I'd like to remind them of Section 20, Paragraph 9 of UAC's Facility Regulations Code. It clearly states our employee rights, and we do not need this nonsense. I suggest you reprimand the individuals responsible and take adequate measures to ensure it doesn't happen again. Do not make me log additional complaints. Bernice Tooley, signing off. I hope this thing is working. Something is happening here and no one knows what's going on. Oh, the power is going crazy. We can't communicate with Central Administration and I've heard something like screams. I don't know. It was so disturbing. Okay, my assistant left me and I'm all alone here. Okay, I'm gonna try to get the network working, but the systems are acting just crazy. I don't know what to do. What was that? Oh. Oh God. Run! No! This is Bernice Tooley, Operations Coordinator stationed in Exis Labs. I would like to file my third formal complaint to Central Authority about the problems with the work environment here in Exis. It has become increasingly difficult to be productive while construction is going on throughout the facility. The construction workers are rude, lack common courtesies, and are overtly sexist. They use our office space as an unauthorized shortcut and track dirt and debris as a result. In addition to their mess, they insist on drilling and hammering during our core staff hours. Some of them have repeatedly made inappropriate comments that clearly fall under sexual harassment. When I approached the construction supervisor to remedy the situation, he told me in no uncertain terms to mind my own business. Actually, his exact words were, "Don't worry your pretty little head about it." We are already on edge with the unexplained events occurring around the facility, and to add this insult to our tight schedule is too much to bear. If I cannot persuade Central Authority to take this complaint seriously, I'd like to remind them of Section 20, Paragraph 9 of UAC's Facility Regulations Code. It clearly states our employee rights, and we do not need this nonsense. I suggest you reprimand the individuals responsible and take adequate measures to ensure it doesn't happen again. Do not make me log additional complaints. Bernice Tooley, signing off.
Excellent. You're back. The inducer is working perfectly, and the teleporter is ready for transport. Here's the situation. There's a teleporter outpost in the other dimension, and it's still operational. It's very powerful, and it has a range that could lead those demons all the way to Earth. I would disable it myself, but it requires two people to do it. One person at the outpost to initiate the teleporter, and another person here to transmit a power surge to destroy it. I know it's a lot to ask, but you'll need to go to the other dimension, find the remote outpost, and initiate the startup sequence. You're our only hope of defeating this evil. I've got the teleporter ready to go. All you need to do is go into the chamber and initiate the sequence. I'll handle the rest from here. But before you go, I want to give you my personal account of what happened here. It explains everything. the advanced teleporter, how the madness started, everything. It's over there on the console. Please take it. The world needs to know the truth. And good luck.
My name is Dr. Richard Myers, and I'm a research specialist stationed in Exis Labs. I don't know who'll be hearing this, but I wanted to alert someone of the disaster at Mars City. What has been unleashed across this base is an unimaginable evil, and we only have a slight chance of stopping it. The research I participated in was the next step in teleportation. To give context to my research, back in 2115, UAC researchers discovered an ancient Martian civilization. At the Erebus dig site, they found a Martian teleportation device. It was non-functional, and all attempts to start it proved fruitless. It took many years, but the researchers managed to learn enough from the device and other wall carvings to reverse engineer it. The first prototype teleporter, codenamed Project Mercury, was built in Delta Labs and became operational in 2139. This teleporter was only capable of short distance travel and limited quantities of matter transference. It could only teleport a single test subject, small animals and chimps usually, across a room. Once testing intensified and technical data increased, we were able to fabricate more powerful teleporters. In Delta Labs Sector 3, Project Gemini managed to increase teleportation across greater distances. In addition to the increased range, we found we could begin transporting human-sized subjects. It was during this stage we began to see the effects of opening up these portals to that strange dimension. Our scientific curiosity overruled the obvious warnings. And under Dr. Malcolm Betruger's direction, we continued experimenting. On Project Apollo, the engineers developed a room-sized teleporter in Delta Lab Sector 4. It was capable of teleporting a small-sized team to destinations on this new dimensional plane. The expedition teams began exploring and setting up small research outposts. We could only teleport small equipment with a Delta 4 teleporter, and this condition frustrated Dr. Betruger. Soon after the success of Project Apollo, plans were drawn and work executed on a new facility, Exis Labs. At Exis Labs, the goal was to create a large teleporter, similar in scale to the one at Erebus. It would be powerful enough to transport large equipment, even dropships, and eventually shorten interstellar travel. Betruger was so impatient on seeing results from this research, he had the engineers start work on the teleporter once the facility reached 75% completion. We had expedition teams set up a teleporter outpost in the other dimension to link up with Exis. It was at this time I began investigating the strange stories I heard over at Delta Labs. I managed to hack undetected into Betruger's personal logs. What I found scared me to the core. Betruger became obsessed with the findings of this new dimension. He started to push experiments regardless of the human cost. His log entries into the occult and how to harness evil powers were truly frightening. The more recent logs detailed how demons, yes, demons, contacted him through his dreams, offering him unimaginable powers. But they demanded he find a way to help them reclaim Earth. It was then I realized that this other dimension was hell itself. By the time I realized his plan, Betruger had started the invasion. Since the Exis teleporter hadn't reached sufficient functionality, I assume Betruger decided to launch the demon invasion on Mars without it. However, the Hell Outpost teleporter is operationally ready, and it's only a matter of time before Betruger decides to use it. I'm going to try to reach Chief Engineer Rhodes in the NPRO facility to divert enough power to Exis, and with a little luck, create a big enough power surge to destroy it from here. I can only pray God will forgive me for my part in all this. Help me make things right. Lord, save my soul. Richard Myers, signing off.
Decontamination process started. Decontamination complete.
I have the teleporter sequence already configured. Just activate the main console. When you reach the outpost, I'll be able to communicate with you. Good luck.
Teleportation will commence in T-3, 2, 1.